Welcome to all. In this video, we study the vector differential calculus, how to check the weather field is irrotational or conservative, and how to find out the values of unknown. Let's understand this thing with the help of example. If the vector field f bar x plus 2y plus az I bar plus by minus 3y minus z j bar plus 4x plus cy plus 2z k bar irrotational, find a, b, c and determine phi such that f bar is equal to del phi. Before going for the example, first of all we understand the keywords. This first term is nothing but our f1. The second term is nothing but our f2. This third term is nothing but our f3. And the given is that it is irrotational, means curl of f bar is 0. Now we write this answer in a 4 step. Step 1 is nothing but the given thing. Step 2 is nothing but what we are using or a formula. Step 3 is nothing but the calculation. And step 4 is nothing but the conclusion. So step 1, they are given f bar is irrotational, that is curl of f bar is 0. Step 2, we are using curl of f bar is 0, and to find and phi, we integrate f1 with respect to dx, considering y, z as a constant. We integrate f3, the term those are free from x in f2, d with respect to dy, when z is a constant. And we integrate f3 free from x and y with respect to dz. Now before going for the solution, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon to get an new updates. As they are given, the f bar is irrotational, curl of f bar is 0. So what is curl of f bar? It is ijk dabba by dabba x, dabba by dabba y, dabba by dabba z of f1, f2, f3 is equal to 0. Now we substitute the value of f1, f2, f3, we get it is f1 value is nothing but your x plus 2y plus az is f1, f2 is bx minus 3y minus z, f3 is 4x plus 4x plus cy plus 2z is equal to 0. Now we find this value, so when we consider the I, we get I derivative of this with respect to y minus derivative of this with respect to z. Now for the next step, we get derivative of, so we have to take derivative of this with respect to x, derivative of this with respect to z. And in the third step, we take a derivative of this with respect to x and this with respect to y. So now we want to take a derivative of this. So we go one by one. So to take a derivative of this with respect to y, this will become 0, this will become 0, and derivative of cy will become only the c. Similarly, when we take a derivative of this with respect to z, we get derivative of minus z as minus 1, then the remaining will become 0 because those are constant. Similarly, when we take a derivative of this, this two terms, the derivative will become 0 and derivative of 4x will become 4. Similarly, when we take a derivative of this with respect to z, x and 2y will become constant, the derivative is 0 and derivative of az is a. Similarly, when we take a derivative of this with respect to x, 3y and z will become constant, that is 0, and derivative of bx is b. Similarly, when we take a derivative of x plus 2y plus az, derivative of x and az will become 0 and derivative of 2y will become 2. As we know that this value is equal to 0, so by considering all these values, we get I c minus of minus 1 minus j 4 minus a plus k bar b minus 2 equal to 0, and 0 is nothing but 0 I bar plus 0 j bar plus 0 k bar. Now by comparing the component wise, we get c minus of minus 1 equal to 0, that is c plus 1 equal to 0, that implies c is equal to minus 1, 4 minus a equal to 0, that is a is equal to 4, b minus 2 equal to 0, that is b is equal to 2. By substituting all these three values into the given f bar, we get new f bar is equal to x plus 2y plus value of a, that is 4z, I bar plus 2x minus 3y minus z j bar plus 4x minus y plus 2z k bar. Now we want to find out phi. Now how we find a phi? Just by integrating f1, f2, f3. But the condition for f2 is free from x and condition for f3 is free from x and y. So in f2 we substitute x is equal to 0. So this will become 0. And in f3 we substitute x equal to 0, y equal to 0. So this two term will become 0. So by substituting all these value we get phi is equal to integration of x plus 2y plus 4z dx plus integration of minus 3y minus z dy plus integration of 2z dz plus c. Now whenever we integrate this x with respect to x, we get x square by 2. Integrating 2y with respect to x, we get 2xy. Integrating 4z with respect to x, we get 4zx. Integrating minus 3y, we get minus 3y square by 2. Integrating minus z, we get minus zy. Integrating 2z, we get 2z square by 2 plus c. So by substituting, we get these values. So by simplifying all this, we get final phi is equal to x square by 2 plus 2xy plus 4zx minus 3y square by 2 minus zy plus z square plus c. So the final conclusion is, the required values are a equal to 4, b equal to 2 and c is equal to minus 1. And the required phi is x square by 2 plus 2xy plus 4zx minus 3y square by 2 minus zy plus z square plus c. Thank you for watching. Visit again. Subscribe the channel. Press the bell icon to get the new updates. Do your best. Thank you very much.